I'm on the subway, New York City. This guy reaches into my purse. He grabs my makeup case. I'm like, uh-oh, I'm about to get mugged by a drag queen. It is on. Because they're big and they can fight, you know what I'm saying? So then he grabs my purse and he goes, I'm gonna hit you. So then I said, if you hit me, you better knock me out. Which was stupid. Don't say that to somebody who's stealing your purse. Don't do that. Because that was his plan. He wasn't waiting for my go-ahead on that one. So, right, so he hit me. He punched me. Don't worry, I can take a punch. I went to public school. So he hit me and I took it. I don't know if it was the adrenaline, but did you ever have one of those balloon clowns as a kid? It was literally like, nope. Nope. I eat those. I even did one of these, like I was gonna morph into Steven Seagal and like karate chop him right in the throat. And then he went to hit me again and I grabbed his arm. And I don't know if any of you have ever been in a fight, but you start to win a fight you were losing and you talk so much crap. Like I grabbed his arm, I was like, man, who you trying to hit? But there was another arm I should have been looking out for. Because that one came out of nowhere. This guy literally, he lifted me up off the floor and tossed me aside like nothing. And the whole time he's picking me up, the only thought going through my head was, oh my God, I must have lost so much weight. Did you see how he threw me? Damn it, I'm skinny. I'm kidding. It was really hard though when he picked me up not to go, wee! This is fun. What are we gonna do next? The second time this happened, okay. Second time my mouth got me in trouble. This one's a biggie. It was with my boyfriend's mom. I know. Let me explain. See, what happened was, here's some important information. My boyfriend is Mexican. Yeah, what up? Hey. Hey. His mom, he's from Texas, like he was born in Texas. His mom was born in Mexico. It's a very important part of the story. So she grew up a little more like what old school beliefs, and if you know any even old school people, they don't have to be from Mexico. You know that they don't sugarcoat anything. They don't have time for it, they don't care for it, they're blunt and honest people. And I can respect that, that's fine. But when you mix somebody who's blunt and honest with somebody that doesn't have a filter, things can happen. So last time I'm in New York, she sees me, comes up to me, first thing she does, put her hand on my stomach. Why is that happening? I don't know why. I don't feel comfortable with that, do you, right? Because how many of us have had the guy that thought it was cute to pinch the fat on your stomach, huh, ladies? Yeah, right, the guy that goes, look at that, you have a tummy, look at that. I'm like, you have 3 seconds to live. Pinch me one more time, and your life is over. Right, so she touches my stomach, she goes, you're getting kind of fat, are you pregnant? Yeah, thank you. That is how I felt. Because first of all, who says that? Who tells a woman she's fat? Every guy in here already knows. The question, do I look fat in this? What is the answer? No, no, absolutely not, right? No, sometimes it's hell no. Sometimes it's, oh my God, baby, no, you look like you lost an ounce. Or whatever unit of measurement will get you out of trouble. But you never tell a woman she's fat, never ever. And you don't say that to me because I can't control what comes out of my mouth. She should know this. I've known her a while. So y'all, I can't be blamed for what happened next because I was provoked. Because the second she said that without pause, I looked her right in the face and I was like, oh, relax, I'm not gonna keep it.